Consider a CSTR that's used to grow cells. And what we're interested in is looking at the case where the flow in, the volumetric flow rate is high enough that we flush all the cells out of the reactor. So we're going to use something called a dilution rate, which uses symbol D. It's the volumetric flow rate divided by the volume of the reactor, which is the same as 1 over the space-time. So look at what dilution rate do we need before we have washout, namely we wash the cells out. So a couple things to notice. We're feeding a substrate, concentration CS0, and of course the substrate leaving has a lower concentration. We're not feeding any cells. So it's important there's no cells in, but there's cells leaving, and this means somehow we had to initiate the reactor by starting with cells in order to be making cells at the exit. But then we can run at steady state without feeding in cells. And so what we're going to look at are mass balances for the substrate and for the cell concentration. And first, let's look at mass balance for the cells. The steady state reactor, so our accumulation term is zero. So this accumulation, we have, in general, concentration of cells coming in, but remember this is going to be zero. So this is our term in. Our term out, same volumetric flow rate, final concentration of cells. And the reason we have these is because there's a rate of generation of cells. And to be general, there's a rate that the cells die. And then this is a volume of the reactor. These rates are per volume. We're going to look at this simplified case where the death rate is zero, okay, RD equals zero. We're just assuming that to simplify the calculations. So if we rearrange this equation, first we're going to also use this definition of dilution rate, so divide through by the reactor volume. It simplifies to the dilution rate times the cell concentration at the exit is equal to the rate of generation per volume. And we're going to look at a case where the rate expression follows the fairly common form. There's a rate constant, concentration of cells, and concentration of substrate, another constant, and a concentration of substrate. So this is the rate we're going to put into this expression. You notice if we do this, if we make the substitution, the cell concentration on both sides disappears, and then we can solve this expression for the concentration of the substrate leaving the reactor. So the concentration of the substrate is related to this dilution rate and the two constants. Something important to notice here, the substrate concentration has to be less than or equal to the inlet substrate concentration. And this expression also, we must have U max greater than D, or the other way of looking at it is their dilution rate, D must be less than U max in order for CS to be a real number, a positive number. So let's now look at a mass balance on the substrate. Again, steady state, so there's no accumulation. There is substrate entering, substrate leaving, and now the rate of substrate reaction times volume. So if we write this in terms of the dilution rate, so what we need now is a relation between the substrate consumption and the cell formation. And I'm going to write it like so, where this is the rate of cell growth. Well, if this number is positive, the substrate consumption must be negative, the rate of forming substrate, if you like. So the negative would be the rate of using it up. So this is a negative term times a negative gives us a positive term. This corresponds to how much substrate, how many grams of substrate is used for every gram of cell that's formed. For example, this number might be 2. So if we just simplify this equation by substituting here in terms of the rate of cell growth, we can compare this equation to this equation, and we can solve then for concentration of cells in terms of how much substrate is used up. This is essentially a stoichiometry relation. And what we're going to do is, for this equation, say the concentration of cells is equal to the inverse of this. We create a new symbol, right, where YCS equals 1 over YSC. So now we have the concentration of cell. It's leaving the reactor in terms of the substrate concentration. And here we have a relation for substrate concentration in terms of dilution rate and the rate constant. So we can just make a substitution here to get the concentration of the cells, YCS, and then CS0 minus the cell concentration from the other mass balance, Umax minus D. So as we increase the dilution rate, eventually we're going to get to the point where the cell concentration is zero. That's washout. So as D increases, eventually at high enough D values, this will go to zero. This is washout. This is going to occur then when CC equals zero. We have washout, which means this equation says we have a relation between the dilution rate and the constants and the feed concentrations. And so we can solve this for, and so just doing the algebra, we now have the dilution rate in terms of the constants where we have washout. And that means CC is zero, and then means we're not using any of the substrate off. And so this means the dilution rate versus the product of these is some indication of how many cells we're making, right? The, if you write flow rate of cells, would be volumetric flow rate times the concentration. And if we say the flow rate of cells per reactor volume, then it's the dilution times the concentration. So that's what we're plotting here. And what the behavior is like, here's washout. So there's some point where we have a maximum. We could actually calculate that maximum. We won't do so here by taking this derivative, setting equal to zero. And when we do so, we can solve for the condition where the maximum is. So, of course, at no flow rate, we have no production. We get the maximum at this dilution rate, and then at the high enough dilution rate, we have washout and no cell formation.